When the term magic is used, you may think of Harry Potter, love-binding spells, secret rituals, or even sage magicians. But where does the term magic come from? And what was its original meaning? Stay tuned if you want to find out. Hello everyone, I'm Angela and welcome to my channel. Today we'll talk about the birth of the term magic. Where does the term magic come from? Since there are Latin and ancient Greek terms, I will pronounce them accordingly. I will leave all the spellings on the screen for those of you who are not familiar with Latin or ancient Greek. According to Bremer, the oldest attestation of the word magus occurs in a passage by the philosopher Heraclitus, as referenced by Clement of Alexandria in the Protrepticos. Here, Heraclitus is explaining who is the object of prophecies. Those who wander in the night, magi, bacchants, maenads, initiates. Therefore, the term mageia, meaning the activity of the magos and magic in a loose sense, first appears in the 1st century BCE. We find it in On the Sacred Disease by Hippocrates and in Plato, among others. It often refers to the Persian magoi, including the famous Zoroaster. Afterwards, the term appears in a number of Greek tragedies, including Sophocles' Oedipus Rex, in most cases with the negative connotation of a charlatan. The correlation between magoi, mageia, and magic, therefore, first occurs in Greek tragedies, and again mainly in reference to Persians. The term was later associated with purifiers and healers, following an inferior theology and cosmology. Herodotus associates magoi with magic, describing them as interpreters of dreams, stars, and sorcerers. To sum it up, in the Greek classical period, magic encompasses a number of practices, such as purification, blood sacrifices, invocation of the dead, the writing of cursed tablets and binding spells, the use of charm and drugs, as well as the fabrication of wax figurines. There are also broader claims attributed to magicians, like drawing down the moon, eclipsing the sun, and controlling the weather. In Empedocles, we also find the ability to resist the onset of old age and drawing back the life force of the dead. In tragedy, rhetoric, and early philosophy, magus is a term of abuse, whereas historians and Aristotelians take the magi or the magoi seriously. These two traditions converge in the 4th century, when the latter group fosters a distinction between real magi and the abusive interpretation of the first group. This doesn't mean that from that moment onwards, magos mageia would become the preferred term to describe magic and those who practice magic. And that's because the Greeks already had a term for magicians and magic. And this other term for magic was goes goeteia, which was used in reference to magical endeavors. And this term remained in use alongside magos mageia. Since mageia was associated with Persian practitioners who pronounced their incantations in a foreign language and in whispers, this may have contributed to give this term a more esoteric and mystical connotation, since the Greeks used to use their own language and speak out loud. Since Greek linguistic purists of the Roman period deemed goes goetia more Attic than magos mageia, the latter never became popular in the later Greek culture. On the other hand, Romans didn't have this prejudice at all, and therefore used magia magicus and magus maga much more frequently than the Greeks ever did. The increasing popularity of the term generated by the Romans allowed magic to become the preferred term to refer to magical practices and magic from that moment onwards, so much so that this was still the case in early modern Europe. The term then came to be the English magic through the old French magique, which derives from the Latin magicus. And there you have it, how the term magic was born and introduced into the English language. Hope you enjoyed this brief overview on the birth of the term magic. Many more videos will come on the topic of magic on this channel. So if you're interested in the topic of magic, subscribe to the channel and activate the notification bell so that you won't miss anything out. If you like this video, smash the like button, leave a comment or any suggestion for a future video down below, and stay tuned for all the academic fun. Bye for now! We are children of the